Dear students, welcome to DAV Moyal Public School, Sita Sawangi. I am your English teacher, Mr. Gajanan sir, and today we are going to do one important topic from our English reader. Its name is tolerance. Its first part. Students, tolerance is a very important quality that you must build up in yourself. If you have tolerance, you can lead a happy path of life. Okay, so let's do self-analysis. Attempt the self-analysis questionnaire given below and know more about yourself. Okay, so there are given three options. You have to select the one. Okay, one example I will tell to you. You are traveling in a train and one of your co-passenger is coughing continuously. You will warn him not to cough near you, change your seat, offer him some medicine and water. Okay, so if you get such type of experience, then which will be the best option? Third one, offer him some medicine and water. Okay, in the same way you have to solve rest of the questionnaire. Okay. So students, for every option, third, if you select third option every time, you will get 5 marks, and for option 2, 2 marks. Give yourself a 0 for every option 1. Suppose if you have selected one option, then you will get 0 marks. Then add your marks and read the observation given in the box. If your score is 30, in between 30 to 20, you are very excellent. Hats off to you. If your score is 10 to 19, you seem to be a fairly tolerant person. Okay? But if your score is 0 to 9, then you have to be at the quality of tolerance in you. Okay, student, now let's see. Tolerance does not just mean putting up with your friends or relatives habits. It has a much wider dimension. Okay, the following excerpt is taken from written by E.M. Forster. The British novelist E.M. Forster wrote the following essay during World War II. This essay was a broadcast on radio by Forster himself. Although more than 75 years have passed since the essay was written, the writer's ideas are still valid. Okay, E.M. Forster has written this essay before 75 years ago. But what he wants to give you the message through this essay, that in our day-to-day life, you means most of us don't like different type of people. And someone don't like nose of the people, someone don't like the way how he talk. Some people don't like to spend time with the people, those who are very talkative. But in life, you will meet different type of people. So you have to interact with them, you have to tolerate, because you can't change the world. And it is not necessary that who will come in your contact, you must love them. You just tolerate them, means make it a habit to tolerate the people. Means just like as a one quality you must add in yourself. On the basis of that tolerance, a civilized future may be built. Okay, if you have this quality, then civilized society can be built. Means E.M. Forster does not believe that we can reconstruct the whole world. We are neither fit nor equipped for that. Hence, the need of peace, tolerance. Okay, we can't change the world, but we can change our approach, our attitude towards the people. We can add the quality of tolerance in ourselves. Tolerance may not be regarded as a great eternity. Okay, means a good quality, established divine principle. Rather, it is a makeshift suitable for an overcrowded and overheated planet. Now see, when you travel, when you go to school, when you roam here and there in your neighborhood, you will meet different type of people, different type of friends, but you have to adjust yourself with them. Then only you can live very happily. We can't move away from our home and from our friends. We have to adjust ourselves with them. So we have to add the quality of tolerance in us. And stand among us, strangers in a queue. We have to stand, suppose if you are going for depositing electric bill, that time you will be unknown to other people. So you have to adjust yourself. Tolerance is not the same as weakness. Putting up with people does not mean giving in to them. Okay? Whenever you adjust with the people, does not mean that you have to live with them forever. Just the writer focus is only to add the quality of tolerance in you. Okay, students, now read these extracts given in your textbook on tolerance given and tick the right option that explains the extract best. They are numbling over each other. People are falling over each other. People contradict, oppose each other's ideas and points of view. People push each other deliberately. So second one is the right answer. So in this way you have to solve this rest of the options. Read the extract properly and tick the correct option from the given three options. Okay. Now students, see given below are few situations. Find out which of these suggest tolerance and which of these imply weakness. Okay, first situation is given. A man sitting next to you in a restaurant is smoking. You are allergic to smoke, but you do not object. Tolerance, weakness. Okay, this is not a tolerance, it's a weakness. You must ask to that person, you must request to him, uncle, please don't do smoking. Like this you can do. Request to him. Okay, now next one, see, you see a man snatching away a beggar's coins. You do not raise alarm and keep quiet. Tolerance, weakness. It's a weakness. Okay, so in the same way you have to solve the rest of the situations. Okay, now students, draft a speech to be delivered in the morning assembly on the topic tolerance, the need of our. You can include in your speech some of the questions given below. Okay, use these questions as a point and try to expand it. Write in your own words. Tolerance is essential for mankind. This point. Without tolerance, even love would perish. Okay. The highest aim of education is including tolerance, okay, inculcating tolerance and including tolerance quality in you. Tolerance enables coexistence. So these all qualities you have to write down. Just write down a speech in your notebook. The excerpt you have read in this unit has been taken from an essay by E.M. Forster. An essay is a written composition to express one's personal ideas or opinions on some topic. Essays can be of various types. Narrative type, writing a storytelling. Descriptive type, describing some place or a thing. Discursive essay, presenting important issues and discussing term, and finally teaching a conclusion based on reason. Okay, so student, this is a discursive essay written by E.M. Forster. Okay students, given below are some words. The one you would associate with tolerance. Okay, so there are some words you have to put a tick mark which is related with tolerance. For example, patience, forbearance, sensitivity. Okay, means open-mindedness. So whatever means, which word you feel that this is a related with tolerance, you just put a tick mark on it. Okay, Okay, students, so the essay by E.M. Forster throws light on the aspect that tolerance is an essential part of our life. Means it's a quality that you have to build in yourself, because tolerance enables coexistence, and without tolerance even love would also perish. Tolerance is essential for mankind. Okay, student, this is the end of your video and today's class. Thank you and have a happy day.